All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Man, thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Trying to break it all down, people. Usually, we're talking about Duck football. That is the case most of the time. Most of the people are here for Duck football. But if you like what I carry here and like what we're doing, stick around for basketball. Let's do this thing. I love basketball. Duck basketball as a kid was definitely one of my favorites. Used to go to Don Monson basketball camp every single year. Used to go to play in the pit all the time as a kid growing up. Huge fan of the hoops. So, let's do it. This year, had some huge aspirations. I already did one video, kind of a preview video for the whole year. And then I really haven't done anything else in the preseason. We've had some ups and downs, had some injuries, had some other sort of stuff to report on. And then now we're ready to go. It is going to be, this week is going to be the first week of the Pac-12 season. And the Ducks start with Oregon State to start it off. So this is going to talk a little bit about kind of the what happened in the non-conference schedule. And then we'll talk a little bit about the Pac-12. And then we'll wrap things up. All right, Ducks, man. We had a lot of aspirations for this year. Huge recruiting class. You got Bol Bol coming in. You got Lewis King. You got these two guys that you know are going to be really top flight players. People are using the words one and done. And I understand why. Definitely get it with Bol Bol. I think Lewis King, I don't know if it's coming off the injury, a little bit of rust or whatever, but the case may be, whatever it is. I definitely know that this team has to gel, right? Everybody knows that, right? So it's a young team mixed with a couple of guys who've been here before, mixed with some older guys who haven't been here before. So you start the year off and it gets a little shaky. That first game, that first loss against Iowa, was pretty alarming. They were hitting threes like crazy and nobody could stop them. Their big men were firing. Everybody was doing well in that one. But that did set you up because Syracuse lost that game as well for a matchup with Syracuse, which is really the matchup people wanted to see out of that tournament anyway. And then so the Oregon got a great game back-to-back with Syracuse. So you kind of got to see right off the jump the Jekyll and Hyde of this team. You got to see kind of the worst one night against Iowa. And I wouldn't say the worst, but you did not play that well. And then you got to see the next night. And Bol Bol at that point in time really was taking things over. You know, for the most part, you know, you've had Amin as well, has been playing well. Amin is basically your best scorer. Pritchard's a better setup guy. Amin's your best scorer at this point. Bol Bol's your best player if he's on the floor. But now he's been injured, right? So then you come down, you get another couple wins, but then that Texas Southern loss was a real wake-up call. It was a close game. I know Texas Southern's had a good game or had a good season this year. They beat Baylor early on, but that was a tough one. Bol Bol was lighting it up, though. He had 32 points that game. So it's not like, you know, you weren't getting offensive production. You just weren't getting offensive production really from anybody else. And that game did go into the 80s, so that happens sometimes. Houston was another loss. You had back-to-back losses. That was a real eye-opener as well, but that was on the road. So go ahead. You're going to get one of those every once in a while, right? You get some good wins. You won both Boise State games. That was big. But you lose the game to Baylor, and the Baylor game was kind of ugly. 47 points. Really couldn't get off the ground. Pritchard was your best scorer. But in that game, Wooten breaks his jaw. So it's like, what the hell is going on here? You can't get out of your own way. King's injured early on. You have Bol Bol. Now Bol Bol gets injured. King's hurt, coming off the injury, but he's not really taking over games. He's got a good stroke from outside. He's really buttery from outside, but he doesn't really take over games. He doesn't put the ball on the floor and dunk over people and take over the way kind of Bol Bol can. And then Amin, man. Amin played really good in the Boise State game. Really came on late in that one. So this is an interesting schedule, the way it breaks down this year, because Pac-12 is not that good. UCLA just fired Steve Alford, and that's the second team we play after Oregon State. So this sets up for, even though Oregon is kind of in a train wreck right now, and the thing is on fire a little bit, so is the rest of the conference. I do think that Arizona State's the best team in the conference right now, not just because I think that. Beating Kansas helps. But they're steady, and they were good last year. I think that USC's a team on the rise, and USC's fairly good. They're going to be fairly good this year and going to be tough to handle with. Utah and Colorado always bring it. They always play well. Cal and Stanford always play well. Arizona, for the most part, is always a bell cow in this conference, obviously. So we know that the Arizona schools are going to be good. We know the Bay Area schools, the mountain schools are going to be good. It's just, and I don't know about Oregon State. I think Oregon State's going to be a heck of a lot better this year as well. So I'd watch out for them as well. I think Oregon State and Oregon might be right now kind of neck and neck. So that's a great way to start the year off, is you get to play Oregon State. You get to have them at home and see what happens. I would not be surprised if Oregon State beat the Ducks by 10 or 15 points. Just not shocked. If the Ducks beat the Bees by 10 or 15 points, not shocked. I have no idea about this one. I do know that both these teams should be competitive for the Pac-12 North. Right now, the Pac-12 North is up for grabs. Washington State, question marks. Oregon State, question marks. Cal and Stanford. You might have Cal win the whole thing at this point. Who knows? So this is a year that Oregon might be able to still make some noise. They just have to keep the ball together. Pritchard is the key thing. If Pritchard can get the ball to the lane, which he can fairly significantly, he's got to be able to kick the ball back out. We got to make those threes. Victor Bailey Jr., I think, is one of the better players on this team. When he starts getting hot and he can start hitting the three, then people start guarding him. Then he can put it on the floor, really get past people. This is an interesting squad this year. I think that not having Wooten for another, five, 6 weeks, is not ideal. He's really your only stopper defensively. You have guys down low that can play fairly well and get boards, but they can't get buckets. And so that's a big problem for this team right now. Oregon needs to be able to score. If they can't score, they're not going to be able to win the Pac-12. There's going to be games where they might be able to lock it down, but now they've lost their big lockdown center for the most part. No idea when Bol Bol comes back, but I'm assuming it's not going to be anytime soon. And I'm assuming when he comes back that he's not going to be full go and might even be possibly injury prone and might not be his only injury. Guy like that, just that's what happens sometimes. You know, you have those guys that are that tall, weird stuff happens with them. They're not that guaranteed. That's why you always got to have a couple, try to see if you can get a couple guys like that on your lineup, because you never know what's going to happen with them centers. It would be great to see everybody get healthy by February, March, and then see what you could do with this team and make a run. I think this team could possibly win the Pac-12 tournament, or at least make some noise, maybe play Arizona State in the final. I think that could happen if you get everybody healthy and get this thing rolling. Only problem is, I doubt you'll get it healthy, and I'll doubt you get it rolling. At this point in the game, it doesn't look that promising. They've had some tough games against some teams they probably should have beaten pretty significantly, and they struggled with. They've had some other games where they have looked good, but then they let the teams come back in at the end and make it reasonable. So, very interesting year. But it should be a fun one. I'll definitely be keeping you guys up to date. My family is all going to go to the Pac-12 tournament in Vegas this year, so that should be a fun one. Hopefully the Ducks put it together so we can get a good representation there. All right, guys. Thank you guys for watching Sports Chat 503. Adios.